So this example is to show how to create a frequency distribution from quantitative data. To do this, you must first find the class width. This problem doesn't say how many classes to have, so if we first have to pick how many classes we want to have to find this class width. Since there appears to be about 50 data points, then it might be best to have about 5 classes. So we'll pick 5 classes for this grouping, and we'll find the class width. The first thing that needs to happen to find the class width is to find the max and min. So we're going to find the range, which will be the maximum value minus the minimum value. The maximum value appears to be 59, and the minimum value is 1. So the range in this case is 58. Since we said we want to have 5 classes, then the class width would equal 58 divided by 5. 58 divided by 5 is 11.6. Now, one thing to remember about class width is you always round up. This one would round up normally, but if it didn't, you would still always round up. So we actually want to go up to 12 for the class width. All right, so now we have to figure out what the classes will look like. The first class should start at the lowest data value. So it's going to start at 1. We're then going to add the 12 to that 1 to get to the start of the next class. So that would be 13. That means the first class actually ends at 12. So now we add 13 to the class width, which would get us up to 25. So that would be the start of the third class. And that means the class before that would end at 24. Now again, you add 25 to the class width of 12. 25 plus 12 is 37. That means that this 25 class ends at 36. Then we take 37 plus 12 to get to 49. And that means that this class then ends at 48. Now, if you add 12 to 49, you get to 61, which is above our highest data value. So this class would start at 61, which means our class we're working on right here ends at 60. Now, with qualitative data, we actually want the classes to actually match up. And so we want to have them actually touching. So we're going to find something called a class boundary. And the class boundary is found by subtracting 0.5 from the 1, which would get us down to 0.5, and adding 0.5 to the 12 to get to 12.5. The reason you add 0.5 is because the difference between 12 and 13 is 1, so halfway between that would be 0.5 difference. So that means this class would actually start at 12.5, and the next class would end at 24.5. This class would start at 24.5 and end at 36.5. The next class would start at 36.5 and end at 48.5. The last class would start at 48.5 and end at 60.5. This way the classes actually touch. You actually see that there's no gap between them, but because all the data that we had were integers, then we don't have to worry about where any of those data fall, because they won't fall on one of those boundary points. It's also useful to have a class midpoint. The midpoint is found by adding the two endpoints of your classes together and dividing by 2. So 12 plus 1 is 13, I'm sorry. And then you divide that by 2, which gets you 6.5. The next one is 13 to 24, so you add 13 plus 24, then divide that by 2, and you'll get 18.5. Notice the difference between these two is our 12 class width. So you can actually just now add 12 each time to get to the next one. So this class would start at 30.5. Sorry, this class's midpoint would be 30.5. This next class's midpoint would be 42.5. Then it would be 54.5. All right, so now the next thing you want to find is kind of tallying up the values. So we'll make a tally column. And what we do with this tally column is we just go through all the data values and say which class do they belong in. So like our 19 here belongs between 13 and 24. So we'll put a mark for there. 18 also falls between 13 and 24, so we'll put a mark there. 17 again falls between 13 and 24, so we'll put a mark there. 1 falls between 1 and 12. 21 falls between again 13 and 24. 22 also falls in that same class. 54 falls in the last class. 46 falls in the fourth class. 25 falls in the third class. 49 falls in the fifth class. And we're going to just keep this process up till we get all of them done. All right. So it turns out that if we just keep doing this, then we get that many numbers that fall in the first class, that many that fall in the next class, that many that fall in that class, that many there, and then, all right, so now we can actually get what we call our frequencies. I'll abbreviate that with FREQ. There are, looking at the tally marks, 6 data values that fell in between 1 and 12, 10 that fell in the second class between 13 and 24, 5 that fell in the third class, 13 that fell in the fourth class, and 8 that fall in the last class. If you add these up, by the way, 6 plus 10 is 16, plus 5 is 21, plus 13 is 34, plus 8 is 42, and we do notice that we actually do have about 42 data values. All right, the last thing we want to sometimes find is the relative frequency. Oops, I'm sorry, let me make that, change that. So the relative frequency is found by taking the frequencies and dividing by the total number of data points. So you take 6 divided by 42, get 0.143. 10 divided by 42 gives you 0.238. 5 divided by 42 is 0.119. 13 divided by 42 is 0.340. And 8 divided by 42 is 0.19. All of these numbers, when you add them up, you should get to 1. Because of some rounding, we actually get to 1.03, which is within the acceptable limits. And now you have a frequency distribution for quantitative data.